I'll fucking know. Everyone, can you hear me okay? Welcome to you all on this rainy Monday evening here in New York City, and welcome to all of you online watching. My name is James John. I'm director of choral activities here at the Aaron Copland School of Music. So just a real brief overview of our choral program. We have three choirs here in the Aaron Copland School of Music: the Queens College Treble Choir, made up of sopranos and altos; the Queens College Vocal Ensemble, which is sopranos, altos, tenors, and basses. Those are our two select undergraduate choirs. And then we have a college community oratorio society, the Queens College Choral Society, that performs major works two times per year. So tonight you're hearing our two undergraduate select ensembles. And it's my great pleasure to introduce to you now my new colleague in the Aaron Copland School of Music, Dr. Morgan Jolley, who is with us for the first time this fall, from coming from most recently Ithaca College. So please welcome Dr. Jolley and the Queens College Treble Choir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It is my pleasure to welcome the treble chorus, as well as Caleb Carman, our collaborative pianist, and Jordana and Najee. Thank you, Najee. Tonight's concert, our theme tonight was on layers, and you can see that in the program. And we discuss how each of these pieces of music are a part of us as humans and our layers and our depth. That last piece specifically really was comprehensive in talking about how many different sides of us there are. And so for this last piece that we hope you will enjoy, it is a cry and a plea for the world to find peace. I hope you enjoy Rosephanye Powell's To Sit and Dream.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. So just a little bit of context about the set of music you're about to hear. So last spring, I was approached by the Parthenia Viol Consort. So a viol consort, in the Renaissance period, they called a group of instruments a consort. So you hear a recorder consort would be a group of recorders, soprano, alto, tenor, bass, of different voice ranges. So a viol consort is really, it's a group of stringed instruments, cello-like instruments, that cross the vocal range from soprano, alto, tenor, to bass. So I was approached by this group in Manhattan to collaborate on a program of Renaissance music, and we hit upon the idea to honor William Byrd and Thomas Weelkes, two Elizabethan composers who died 400 years ago in 1623. So it's their 400th anniversary. So a few quick things. So the Elizabethan, this time in England was a rich time of artistic growth. It's the time of Shakespeare. So the music you're hearing, both of these composers would have seen Shakespeare's plays, and Shakespeare would have been familiar with this style of music. Our first composer, Thomas Weelkes, was most well known for secular music, and the first piece on the program, To Shorten Winter's Sadness, is a ballad. It is a short fa-la-la madrigal, and the text is about the nymphs coming out of the woods to celebrate, to go to a costume ball in the winter, to shorten winter's sadness. So it reminds me of the play A Midsummer Night's Dream, the text. Then that's paired with a longer madrigal in two parts, O Care Thou Wilt Dispatch Me, and Hence Care Thou Art Too Cruel. Weelkes was a complicated person. He was a brilliant man. Worked for the Church of England, but had trouble. He loved to go to the tavern, and he lost several jobs, or at least one main job due to his drinking, and so you'll hear, I think, in the two madrigals that the Hence Care and O Care, they are rare melancholy fa-la-la madrigals, and I think you can hear at one point in the second madrigal, there are the words, come music, sick man's jewel. So Weelkes is reaching out to his love of music to help console him and us.
To short winter's
Thank you. So I realized I didn't finish my train of thought. So the Parthenio Viol Concert, so we are collaborating. What you're seeing is half a program. So in December, we're going to be giving the same program with the Viol Concert, and it will be a mixture of solos. They'll be playing along on some of the pieces that you're hearing now. So it should be a rich tapestry of Byrd and Weelkes. So the next set of music by William Byrd. William Byrd was a very different musical personality than Weelkes. An older man than Weelkes, though they died in the same year, older by about maybe 20, 25 years. Byrd was one of the most famous musicians in England, and he was a Catholic in a Protestant country where Catholicism was an outlawed religion. So the music you'll hear in this set was probably composed by Byrd in secret for a patron, for a Catholic patron, and performed probably in a country home in secret. Because Elizabeth I was not nice to Catholics at the best of times. The larger point, the music is particularly heartfelt, I think, on Byrd's part, for the reason that it was essentially banned.
Thank you.
So we have to change standing for this last piece by Thomas Weelkes. So for this last piece, we're back to English madrigal, secular piece. So this particular piece is part of a book of madrigals entitled The Triumphs of Oriana. And around 1603, a composer named Thomas Morley commissioned maybe 20 or so of the most famous, well-known composers of the time. So that would be Thomas Morley, John Farmer, so on and so forth, to compose pieces in honor of Elizabeth I. And a nickname for Elizabeth was Oriana. So all the madrigals in this collection start off with different words, and then they come to a final refrain that says, "Long live fair Oriana," meaning long live the queen. One thing, if you've ever taken many of you, as undergraduates, you have taken music history, of course, this madrigal is often used as a prime example of word painting. So for example, at the beginning you'll hear, as Vesta was from Latmus Hill descending, and on the word descending you'll hear descending scales. She spied a maiden queen ascending, you'll hear ascending scales. Then at one point you'll hear first 2x2, then 3x3. So at 2x2 you'll hear two voices, then 3x3 you'll hear three voices, and then at one point you're left all alone and you'll hear one single voice, so on and so forth. So it's a lot of fun. So enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming. Good night.